Ladies and gentlemen, the title of this video is not wrong. It's not wrong. Science versus medicine. And yes, medicine is based on science. At least we hope so. I mean, it is. However, science is a counterintuitive understanding of our world. And medicine is an intuitive application of science. They are not the same. They are not the same. No. And sometimes the intuitive part in application of science when it comes to medicine defeats the purpose of science. So let me tell you about my journey with COVID-19. One day, you know, half a year ago, my mother and I got what we believe to be a stomach flu. Our stomachs got attacked because our stomachs are probably the weakest parts of our bodies when our lungs are relatively strong, in spite of living for so long in New Jersey with poor air quality. Something has to be done about the air quality in New Jersey, believe me. All that green talk and the air quality is still pretty bad, and we have bad air quality days pretty much every week. So, what happens? However, looking on a hindsight a couple of weeks later, we realized that we did indeed have COVID-19. And then, blood tests at our doctors, our primary care physicians, proved that we did indeed go through the COVID-19. What did I do? What does medicine say? Medicine, you know, the doctors on the TV would be telling you, even if you went through COVID-19, you should keep on wearing masks, and you should keep on wearing 2 masks, 3 masks, as long as you can breathe somehow. That's ridiculous. That's absolutely ridiculous. It makes no sense. If anything, if you already have antibodies in your bloodstream, in your body, if you have antibodies, then the best bet is not to wear a mask and to keep on exposing yourself to COVID-19 to keep the antibodies going, to keep the immunity going. That's your best bet. And you're going to ask, what is the number of people who have been fully vaccinated, you know, and they still go through the COVID-19? So the number of hospitalization, according to what's his name, Dr. Chokshi from New York, according to him, the number of hospitalization of people who have been fully vaccinated is 3%, and the number of people dying of COVID-19 is 0.5%. Of all the people dying, only 0.5% are the people who have been fully vaccinated. And of all the people hospitalized, only 3% are the people who have been fully vaccinated. So vaccination does work. But my opinion, the reason those people got in medical trouble and died is either the immune system is compromised, or they listened to doctors too much, not to science, but to the doctors. And they kept on wearing masks, kept on protecting themselves instead of letting the immunity keep on going. That's what I did. So I started going to the place where nobody was wearing a mask. And nobody was wearing a mask in Elizabeth by the chin-up bar in Warrenenko Park. So I kept on going over there religiously. And I was, of course, doing more chin-ups until, I got inflammation in my left elbow when I slowed down. And in addition, I decided to get fully vaccinated. So before my first dose of vaccine, I decided that I don't want to have problem with having too high a levels of antibodies when it comes to COVID-19. And a month and a half before vaccination, I did start wearing a mask when I was going to the chin-up bars. And in addition, because my left elbow got inflamed, guess what happens? For a month, I didn't go at all. Then for half a month, I did go with a mask, you know, just to lower the antibodies in my bloodstream to be ready to receive the vaccination. Then I got the first dose and second dose. And after second dose, My idea is to keep my immunity ongoing for as long as possible. What does it mean? Whenever possible, whenever I am not absolutely required, I do not wear a mask and I try to mingle with as many people as possible. And I do not even use those, you know, antibacterial, antiviral, you know, anti-germ, you know, wipes in the store. I don't use them. You know, when I come home, of course, I'm going to wash my hands before I pick something and put it in my mouth with my hand. But I'm not going crazy. You know, I'm not going crazy because that's counterintuitive. Once you are fully vaccinated, in my opinion, I'm not a doctor, I'm not a scientist, I'm just common man, but I have my logic. And I can look at science and I can look at medicine and see that science doesn't exactly agree with medicine. It's not the same, okay? Because many people think that science is the same as medicine. No, it's not. You know, once again, science is counterintuitive. When medicine is intuitive, okay? And it does apply science, but in an intuitive way, which sometimes defeats the purpose of science. So if you are fully vaccinated, and most especially if you had side effects after the vaccination, guess what? The side effects are telling you that your body has been working on creating antibodies. That means the vaccination did take place and you do have antibodies. If you didn't have any side effects after vaccination, it is possible that the vaccination did not take, that you do not have antibodies. That's possible. Could have happened. Possible, yes. Certain, no. So vaccinations are not 100%. Initially, they were saying they are like 95% effective. So, you know. But most especially if you had side effects, it's probably almost certain that the vaccination took. So your best bet, in my opinion, and I'm not a doctor, I cannot give you medical advice. This is just my personal opinion. Guess what? My opinion is that you should not wear a mask and you should expose yourself. Because by exposing yourself, you're gonna keep the immunity going on. The immunity gonna hold. Because you expose yourself, your body creates more antibodies and you know, it keeps on going. But if you, for example, wear the mask religiously and you have no reason to do it because your immune system is not compromised, then it's very likely that within half a year all the immunity gonna be gone and you're gonna need another series of vaccination. Like why not let the nature happen? You know what I'm saying? Eventually, you know. Yes, why not? But there is a reason why people do not trust scientists. Why the insane clown posse says what they're saying. I'm not gonna say it because I want people under 18 to be able to view this, even though I'm not making this for children. This is not aimed at children, but you know, I'm not gonna be cursing. However, you know, you can imagine, you know, that people don't trust scientists. So there's a reason for it, because scientists think at the highest level, and the highest level of thinking is abstract ideas, conceptual thinking. So for example, you know, there may be a situation, let's say that you know, unfortunately we find ourselves under a limited nuclear attack, or there is an EMP attack, and the scientists are saying that double wrapping your car, your vehicle, in in the aluminum foil, not gonna help against EMP pulse. And then gonna be some men or women who gonna actually be not too close to the place of the origin of the EMP pulse. And they're gonna be some distance away. And actually, their car is gonna work when their neighbor's cars not gonna work. And they're gonna say, those scientists are just lying, you know? So in a survival situation, I would take the words of the scientists with a grain of salt. because for the major part they are right. But there's always, you know, situations which they do not think about because they think in the big conceptual way. But you know, on the ground, when you think about it, it may not be the case. That's part of the reason why people do not trust scientists, you know, because they always, oh, another case, you know, cigarettes cause cancer, you know, and it's epidemiological studies, but, and you're gonna say you cannot rely on them, but the correlation is so freaking out of this earth, it's so astronomically high that you cannot deny it. It's just incredible. And still, you're of course gonna find one man who lived over 100 and who smokes cigar every day or two or three. That's gonna happen, you know. Because reality check, if you wanna live really, really long time, it's really not up to you if you wanna live over 100 years of age. It's mostly your genetics. However, the way you're gonna live your life, you know, quality of life, it is up to you. Quality of life, you should take care of yourself. And you know, listen to the scientists with a grain of salt, and listen to the doctors, understanding that they do use intuition, and sometimes it defeats the science. And with this, I will end, and please give me a thumb up and subscribe, and have a great day.